So it goes like this. We check so three check the three check box. First we check the check 0 dot is check, and then we check for the check milk, I guess, is check, and then finally we have the third check box, which is check coffee dot is check. So we have three check box. We check three check box here, and then you create a variable here, additional price 0, and then it's if it's true for is check, means that we add 5,000 rupiah here. So if the syrup check is true, then we add 5,000 rupiah. Else, we do nothing. Just simply do nothing. So and then we're going to copy paste these codes here and also here, and then finally we add the additional price on the base price, and then we display it on screen. So we just update the price dot text here, and I'm going to use the similar method like this. So we just put the rupiah here dot a dollar curly bracket, and then call the base price at with additional price. So we will have the correct price here. So let's try play it again. This is the base price, 1,000 rupiah, 1,100 rupiah. Then if I take this one, 25,000. I take this one, 30,000, and take this one, 35,000. If I untick one of it reduced by 5,000 rupiah. So if I untick all, uncheck all, it pays it back to the base price. Okay, so that's how you work with the checkbox here. So next one, if the confirm button press, move to the other activity with layout looks like in figure 2. So we're going to create a new activity for it. Go to the project app java com, and then right click on the package name, new activity, and then should be empty activity. Name it as result activity. So we have a layout, yeah, to handle this result activity. Just press finish and just look for the layout. So it has the text on top, and it has the queue number. The queue number, we're going to talk about the queue number. The queue number means that its order, its new order will increment the queue number by one. Okay, so the first customer should have one, number one customer, and the next customer should have queue number two, and so on and so on. How do we handle this? Do we need to save it inside text or inside the database? And if you look more, you can, there's a hint here, which is use the companion object to store the data, the queue number, conveniently. So in this case, we're going to store the queue number using the companion object from the original main activity. So we are about to do it right now. So okay, so we already have the result layout. So in here, we will put the text view, and then you may attach it to the top, left, right, and make it match constraint, right? So it'll be 16, 16, yeah, I guess, and then make it bold, center, and thank you for your order. Thank you for your order. Your queue number is, just like that. And then you drag drop another text view and put it on top, put it on left, put it on right. Always met constraint here. Should be 16. Should be 16. Should be 8, I guess. And we're going to have giant text here. The giant text, bold, 36 SB, and you can change it manually by change the number here, 45 SB, center, guess 55 SB. Okay, should do it. Right, we have a giant text, and for the queue number, and then we state what user request. Okay, what user order. So I'm going to put another text here. Drag to the top, left, right, max constraint, 16, 16, and 8, or 16 probably, and then center it on screen, and just this one to your order, enter, okay, just like that, your order, okay, so, the last one we need is create the button, order another or reorder, yeah. So just put it on the bottom of screen. Match constraint, set the distance, I set 16, and then rename the button to button reorder, and then change the text here, reorder or order another, right? So to consistent with the style of the button, I'm changing the button color to be consistent with previous button, right? Okay, so we have this layout. Now first thing first, we work with the component object here. So back to your main activity, so we're going to create a component object, main object here, and then create a variable, variable the queue number, which is start from 1. Okay, so go to your resolve activity, we adjust the number, which is here. I think I forgot to set ID for it. TXT queue, yes. The dialog, it's show that you want to adjust the layout. Yeah, adjust the name layout for other stuff that connected with this one. Just press yes, okay, and go back to your resolve activity. We change that text queue dot text and take the number from the main activity. So we use the dollar here and open it in curly bracket and type in main activity dot queue. So we take the number, take the integer from the main activity. And next one, because we want to send the data through the intent object, we want to send the hot or ice, and then the spinner, and then the additional item like extra syrup or extra milk and so on. We're going to send the data through the intent object. So back to your main activity, we're going to add the button, the confirm button here. So set ID for your confirm button to btn confirm, enter, yes. And back to your main activity, just add the listener, set on click listener, and create the intent object for intent equals intent, and then you set this for the first parameter, and this one should be the result class.java, right? And then we put several extra. First, the spinner, the spinner name, or the coffee flavor that you want. So you create constant first for coffee, equals coffee. It's just a random string, okay? And then put it here, coffee, comma, take the string from the spinner simply by calling the spin coffee dot selected item dot to string. Simple as that. To grab anything that you choose from this spinner, okay? Since this is one is not object, it's just simply a string. It's, you can do it, do the methods like this, okay? Next, we want to send the hot or ice, yeah, hot or ice. So if the, I think I forgot to name the switch ID here. Yeah, switch style. Oh yes, I've done it. I forgot about it. Okay, switch style dot is checked. Let's take a look. If check means that it's hot, right? Hot cappuccino. So I'm going to send or put extra. I think I'm going to merge it with this one. So let's say type this one as hot, and then you leave it space here, and then concat it with this one. So it will be hot cappuccino, hot latte, hot whatever you choose on the spinner. So we can delete this one, it's unnecessary. And yeah, just like that, we have this coffee, hot or ice. For the else is the opposite of hot, which is the ice. So we change it to ice here. Next, we're going to send the additional item, which is extra syrup, extra milk, or extra coffee. So if check syrup dot is check here, and we're going to put the intern extra, but remember there is an additional catch here. So if you choose the extra syrup, and means that you have to add the flavor information. So if I take the honey here, it will be extra honey syrup. Okay, extra honey syrup. So grab the radio button first, which radio button that has checked as true. So if radio chocolate dot is checked like this, else if radio honey dot is checked, and finally just simply call else, right? Because radio button only take one valid value. So we have var flavor, which is empty string, and if the chocolate have been checked, so you just type chocolate. If honey checked, just type honey, and of course the rest of it is coffee, just additional coffee flavor, coffee. Right, so we have three flavor here, and then we create the put extra, another put extra here, but don't forget to add additional flavor constants. Go back here, flavor, and then we simply write similar thing like this, extra plus. Or let's say we are going to use the concatenation here, $the flavor here, extra honey syrup, extra chocolate syrup, or extra coffee syrup, right? So we just create these strings, yeah, just create this, the extra flavor syrup, and so on and so on, right? Next, how about the milk and coffee? I think it's very straightforward. if the check milk is checked, just copy this one and control V. Or you may combine merge all string to become one string and then set it all. Okay, we are going to do that. So let's say we have a global string here, var flavor, or yeah, flavor string, which is flavor string, which is still empty here, and then forget about the intent here. We just set it as flavor string here equals or plus equals. Okay, and then copy paste this one, put it here, and change it to extra milk. Okay, finally, last one, the honey. I mean, it's not honey, it should be coffee. Yeah, coffee. Oh, wait, I make a mistake here. It should be vanilla here. Vanilla, right? It's because it consists of chocolate, vanilla, and honey. Chocolate, vanilla, and honey. Okay, there is no coffee here. So this one should be checked. Coffee is checked, and then we put extra coffee in it for the flavor. And because we merged all the flavor into one flavor string, we're going to send it to the intent, to the intent flavor. So we delete this one and just the flavor string str. But as you can see here, we merge it all into a single line, so it will look ugly. It will look all like a condensed strings, and we're going to fix that later. Okay, simply just create this put extra and send it all to the widget. Finally, because it shows price, so we are about to send the price also. Send anything that written in here, so the txt price, right? So where we should put it in the very bottom, the intent dot put extra, and then we create another constant price like this. Go back to the bottom one, price, and then should be the txt price dot text dot to string. Okay, and finally we have the intent, I'm sorry, the start activity to start another intent, another main activity, just like so. Okay, and play it,